Hello everyone and welcome to Emir Online. So I just recorded a video about this from my starting perspective as the new persistent world has just been activated. But something went wrong, my recording is lost. I'm pretty pissed off about it to be honest, but there's nothing to do about it. I was really satisfied with the video. But anyway, we're going to go back into the game. A little bit further than I wanted initially, because we have already skipped the very first part of the game. Which probably means that this will probably also be a shorter video than my previous one, which was half an hour. Because I've already done the first basic steps. But I'm going to look at them again and tell you what I did and things like that. This game is still in an early alpha stage. It's in closed alpha. So if you don't have a key, you cannot play it just yet. The developer has is selling some keys on his website. On, I think, the first of every month, you can get some. You can buy a key from the developer. So if you are interested in it, make sure to take a look at it on the 1st of April. I suppose there will be new keys again. And if you get lucky, because they run out really fast every time. But if you get lucky, you might get one of their keys. It's developed by only one guy, and I think he did an amazing job so far. It's an MMORTS, by the way. I haven't actually said that yet. It's a base builder. You have a instanced town where you can just build it up, create your armies, things like that. Then you can get to a bigger campaign map and move your units around, things like that. It's, games like Tribal Wars and Trevian have done it before, but this game is much more in-depth and much more about the economy, because simply surviving, staying alive without seeing a single enemy can already be quite a challenge. We're just going to join the game now, and you'll see what I'm talking about. So this is the persistent game, which means that it lasts a lot longer. You also have the real-time games, which are generally for a smaller amount of players. And they just go a lot faster than these persistent games. These persistent games are meant to last, I don't know exactly how long, but don't expect this to last any shorter than a month. I think that it will last many, many months, to be honest. So we have the campaign map here. The first mission was to settle. I've just settled in the first territory that I came across, or actually the territory that I started in, which is generally a smart thing to do. You can explore further, but you can get into all kinds of issues by doing so. You see that there's some animals on the map. These will provide you with food, which you really need at the beginning stage of the game, because you don't start with a lot, and if you don't... if you don't attack these animal groups, then you'll just die of hunger. I'm going to cough now. Give me 1 second. Sorry, I might cut that out. I'm not sure yet. I might forget once I need to cut things out. Anyway, I've already killed quite a few animals, which means that I have enough food to last me a couple of days. Which will hopefully get me to a position where I can build farms. Because in this game, you cannot start out with farms. You really have to start with hunting. This is basically a Stone Age game, at least at the start. You will at some point go to the Bronze Age and maybe even other ages as well. But you really start out in the Stone Age. So a lot of very basic buildings. Let's actually just take a look at our town, which is of course called Babylon. You will see that not a lot has been built yet. I'm really just starting out, and from here I need to expand further. Waiting display. I have to say that the art in this game is really awesome. There's not a lot of it yet, but it looks really cool. So this is my little town. There are some houses over here. You can see that there are some slums. Slums are basically buildings where your people start in, and if there's no other house to move into, they will build one of these slums themselves. So I should probably build some more houses. Do I not have empty ones anymore? No, it doesn't look like it. So I need to build some more houses to make sure that I don't have any slums. Because it's bad for my health, bad for my intelligence. Which simply means issues for my people. It's just better to have them in good houses. There's a lot of children, mostly. Let's see if I tear down some of them, if they just move. Or that they build new ones. It would be nice if they would just move in with already existing families. But I don't know if that's how it works. This one is empty. Alright, anyway, we have gathered a lot of resources, as you can see here. At the start of the game, you can actually see it here as well. We have 257 meat, which should last for quite some time. Plus 2 apples, hey, that's good. It used to be plus 0.1, so I'm glad with this. It will drop with 1.3 every minute, or every hour, I mean. So that should last us quite some time. We also have fish. Now, we are not producing any fish, this is just found resources. So once we run out of these fishes, we'll start losing a lot more meat again. But I think that for a couple of days, maybe 3 or 4 days, I just don't have to hunt anymore. Which means that I can increase my population during that time. And yeah, hopefully just become stronger like that. You can see my growth here as well. It's pretty decent. We have a growth from 5.1 in total and 1.6 in active population. Now, a generation lasts 24 hours. So it lasts me 24 hours before I get 1.6 active people with more than I have right now. So it's a pretty slow-paced game. I think these are on what kind of scale are these? I'm not sure what the production cycle exactly is. It's either 60 minutes or 90 minutes, but I'm not sure. Does it say anywhere? Can I move my mouse over it, perhaps? I'm not sure. It should say somewhere, I think. Every 90 minutes. Okay. So that means if the production cycle is every 90 minutes, the usage cycle is also 90 minutes. So it will take a long time before I get out of food by now. What else do we have to show? Well, we have some basic buildings here. We have a hunter here, which is gathering some of this meat. We have a flint collector here, which gathers flint, which is used by the tool maker in turn. I might actually need more flint. Yeah, it's minus 1.1. Production is, let's see, 1.6. So I might build another one. I think I have some population left. Yes. So let's actually do that. Flint collector plus 1.6. Yes, thank you very much. This just allows it to go into the plus again. We could lose some of it because we actually have a lot. Which means that I might set it to sleep again, or I don't know yet, but I mean, we just have to take a look at it, what I want to do with it, I don't know yet. We have a gathering camp, which simply provides me with some food, some carrots, this one. There's two woodcutters, as well lumberjacks, which of course provide me with wood, which is probably pretty self-explanatory. We have another farm, which produces apples. Now, it's only effective for 52%, which is because, I can actually show you, that's, where is it, gathering camp. You can see that the apples are very spread out, so they just need to get very far to actually produce anything. I see that I have enough people to maybe build another one, but it will be difficult to find a good spot for it. This gives me 38, can I make it higher than 38? Would like it to go to 2.4. If I go further here, no. I think 38 is the best I can do right now. I'm going to build one more because it's a plus is a plus. Basically, it's that simple. And especially food is something that is very important in this game. If you run out of it, your people will simply die and you don't want that. I am making some, I want to get a stock of plus 10. You might be wondering why not just use everything? At some point you will be able to make farms and you actually need the product to make more of that product. So if I have 10 apples, I can make 10 farm fields for apples. Which is, like I said, the reason why I'm keeping some in stock. This is going plus 0.2, which means that it will take me about 8 hours to get one extra. These two already have 10, so I don't have to carry out anything. I can just produce what I create. And yeah, that's just at a good level right now. I have a lot of leather, you can see here, which means that I can just produce a lot of houses, things like that, which is very useful, of course. My food production for now, it's too low, but I have so much food right now that I can last for quite some time. I would like some more water. I only have one water collector and I can't make any more of them in this area because there is a limit to how far you can build, which means that I need the idea for a water well. And the way ideas work is in this game, you don't really get a set tech tree. But based on certain actions and certain needs of your population, you will get ideas, which simply means that the people think, hey, I need X or I need Y. And they get an idea around it, which allows you to research that idea. And once you have researched it, you can get a building or a unit or whatever that is fitting to those. What the hell is this? All right, so it's going good with my people. And we get 8 extra families, which I say to hell yes. So we've got a nice population now. I'm glad this happened, especially now that I'm filming this video, of course. Because it just shows that early on you get some of these events which really help kickstart your population. And it's very useful to just have this. I hope I'll get some more ideas soon as well so I can advance further. I need to build some more houses, actually. Let's start with that. Housing, there we go. So what I always like to do is... let's build these things first. Is to have 3 rows between my... I like to build in layers, basically. So this is my first layer. This would be my second layer. And then I would build a third layer out here. And then a fourth one, etc., etc. It allows me to kind of guess how big things become, and the way I just like to protect it that way, it becomes slightly easier to defend things, in my opinion. I might actually be slightly wrong about that. Should have maybe made it 4, because I can make defense towers as well, which I can't right now, which I just thought of at this moment. So I've mostly done it because you can get... What the hell is going on here? I don't know. Anyway, because I thought road on the left, wall in the middle, and road on the right. But the roads aren't really important at this moment, so I might just not build roads and some towers instead. I don't know yet. I'll have to think about it later on. Let's build a few more houses. 1, 2, 3... I can just keep building here, that's nice. And then this. Making sure that they have housing rather than the slums. I think I already stated this. It just means that my intelligence is a little bit higher and the health is higher because they have a roof above their head. And they don't catch a cold because of that. So I'm always trying to make sure that I have enough houses whenever I can. Yeah, I think that with these houses, I should be able to get everyone out of the slums pretty much. I mean, these houses are all full, but yeah, I think that we should make it pretty much. And if not, I can build a few more houses. I have the hammers to do it. I actually have some inactive, so I'm going to build another toolmaker. Let's see, toolmaker. There we go. I might actually just make 3. I'm not going to use one of them. Just going to put it on inactive, but it's good to have them. And it's nice to have them all together. I'm going completely crazy and I'm going to even build 2 more. It's actually a free building, so that's fine. So then we have just 5 in this area, which means that I can keep producing tools for quite some time. And I'll just put a couple of them on inactive. Let's see, what is the next step? Do I need anything else? So interesting about this is when you go to the world map, I have said that I found some resources. All these empty areas, when you walk over them, you get certain events. Only the first time that you walk over one of these fields. And these events give something like... They can be both bad and good, but the further you go away from your main base, the bigger the chance becomes that it's a bad event. While if you stay quite close to your area, most of the events will be good. I actually had only one negative one, which was I lost some food. I could choose between losing some population or losing some food. And I mean, I only lost like 4 grain and 4 meat, I think. And on 251 meat, that's almost nothing. So yeah, most things were just positive, like finding some loot. I didn't actually find any population. Sometimes you also get events like families that want to join you. But this time I didn't actually get any of those. But I mean, that's fine. It's nothing too... It's nothing negative, at least. But yeah, you can see that I've scouted in this area a little bit. I've scouted in an area of these 25 squares, I think. Yeah, these 25 squares. And yeah, at some point I will scout further, of course, to find more good stuff. I've also found some more meat walking around, also known as animals. Actually, still shows here. That's odd. I think I found more here. Oh yeah, here. So apparently, maybe just scouted information stays on the right side. I don't know. But, it's useful to know, at least, that these animals are here. I think that I'm running out of time for this video. Or actually, I have plenty of time, but I'm running out of things to talk about. I'm probably going to do more videos about this game. I just don't know how often things like that, because yeah, it just depends what happens. Sometimes you have days where nothing really happens, where growth is just kind of slow. I need to cancel some of these buildings. Putting you to... Actually, I have the population for it right now. I think I'm just going to keep them for a little bit. I mean, this is probably minus 10, which means that I can't do this for too long, but I mean, having some hammers in stock is really nice. You just notice how much I have in stock right now. It's pretty crazy. But yeah, it's useful at the start at least. And I'll probably only decrease in resources the coming days, especially, of course, in food resources. And it will take some time before stocks are actually increasing rather than decreasing. It's just at the start you just have a nice little stockpile because of the scouting. I think that's everything I wanted to talk about. So I'm going to end the video here. If you like this video, don't forget to leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. And if you want to say anything about this video or about my channel in general, don't forget to leave it in the comment section below. Thank you all for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye-bye.